we've created a dimensioning technology to measure packages and objects. I shop online. I always have to pay for expensive shipping fees. And the reason for this is something called dimensional weight. It's a concept that couriers like UPS and FedEx introduced to charge shipping fees based on the size of a package rather than its actual weight. Problem is that online retailers don't really care about dimensional weight, and so often would package their items in boxes which are way too big. And so the end result is leaking tens to hundreds of thousands of dollars in extra shipping fees, and the people that end up paying for it are the online customers. The New York trip we found out through Velocity, one of the emails, and so we applied through the trip, and we were very fortunate to be selected as one of the companies. The reason for the trip is to introduce companies, Canadian companies, to New York City to see the different market size. We wanted to meet customers there, we wanted to talk to investors there, and we wanted to talk to the locals there to get the experience of how New York works and how business is done in New York City. The first night we arrived at Phillips Lytle, and there we basically met other companies like us from Canada, and we got to pitch our pitch to Kelly Hoey, as well as Mike Kirkup, and they gave us really good feedback on a company.
We've been selling a beta unit, so we've sold to shipping departments, two e-commerce retailers, and a courier.
Okay, so like five units, four units?
Right now we have, so we sold officially two, and we have three more in pre-orders.
And what's your average sales cycle?
I think between 6 months.
6 months, and how much do you charge?
So we charge $3,000.
And it's per unit?
Per unit.
And that 6 month sales cycle will net one unit sale typically?
Well, that we haven't figured out quite yet. So we, yeah.
So have you seen a customer buy more than one so far?
Yes, some of customers buy two units.
Okay, so potential upside is they might spend $6,000.
Correct.
Are you worried about the economics of that? That you've spent 6 months selling somebody and that they buy somewhere between $3,000 and $6,000 for the product? No.
This is an interesting question. I don't know how to answer that.
So everybody talks about this in SaaS. They don't talk about it with hardware companies, but you're in the valley of death, right? Where you have found a business that can exist because there are people who want to buy something at a certain price point, but it takes too long to sell to them at that price point for you to survive. It doesn't matter how long the flywheel lasts, you're not going to make it back.
We thought going in that we knew a business model, but then they ripped us apart and gave us a better business model.
It might be that your revenue model needs to get flipped. That you get the hardware for $600, but you only get it for that because you've now signed on to a 3-year package with your, at this month per month, and here's what you're getting, and you're getting these updates and blah blah blah.
So
because once they have your hardware, how are they? How are they going to go to somebody else for anything else, right?
Yeah.
You may want to spend some time with someone who has had this kind of product software, and what is your sales pitch, and toy with what the pricing model is.
What's the most common objection that you get when you sell? What's the most common objection? What's the biggest problem they bring up?
Well, so far, to be honest, we've called up people and we pitched and then they said, okay, we bought it. So we've only sold 2-3. So we actually
Only called three people.
We've actually only called one person and they pitched to the other two. So they referred us to the other two people. And because the reason we did this is because we're still in our beta phase where we're trying to make sure our product is still.
It's not to tell that part of the story.
Oh, yeah. So
that makes a big difference.
Okay, yeah. So we still have beta products, not an actual product.
Google has shit that's been in market for 10 years they call beta.
Okay.
Google is not helpful to you.
Our product sells itself. Our customers are our best advocates. We pitched it once, and we now have three customers because they sold it to somebody else.
Yes.
And that's where
there's your story. You need to be able to say this because now someone's like, okay, now I want to lean in and hear more. When you first started, I was like, oh, Jesus Christ, 6 months to sell something. It's either a piece of shit or they don't know how to sell.
Or they're an insurance company.
So that was actually very helpful. So now we can have a service model where people pay $6 a day to have to be able to dimension their products. It's much more easier barrier to entry for a lot of people. So $3,000 right up front, or $6 a day, right? So we didn't understand that until we actually learned from Mike Kirkup and Kelly. So thank you for selecting us. It was an awesome program.